So today, we're switching out tires. Finally got the tires. I got some Mickey Thompson ET drag slicks for the car. Obviously, it's out here running. The side skirt's hanging off a little bit. But tires are over there. I'm gonna get these radials off, trading them to a buddy. So he filled my bottle for me. The car's here, it's running. I'm gonna give it a bath, take some pictures. This will be the last time it'll be on the radio for a little while. I didn't mind the radials though. They were good on the street. I mean, I used them for a while. I used them at the track a couple times. I think I made 5 passes on those. 5 or 6 passes on them. And then just a lot of street stuff. But other than that, I mean, it's pretty good. We already got the UMI suspension on the car, it's dialed in. We're gonna have to change up some shock settings and everything for compression and rebound for a slick. And hopefully it doesn't hit the fender well with the tire. So yeah, like I was saying before, we got some Mickey Thompson slicks that are gonna go on the car. We are not gonna be on the radio. We're gonna see how these test out. We're gonna do a couple hits on the street. We're gonna do a couple hits at the track. Hopefully ATCO stays open long enough for us to actually make it out there and get a testing tube pass in. Obviously these slicks are not brand new. I do not feel like spending the $300-$500 to get brand new slicks just to do the, you know, the purpose of a slick is burning them out. So, I mean, obviously it's still a V6 car. I'm not gonna run through these fucking tires. But these are a 28 by 10.5, I believe. Somewhere around here. Yep, 28 by 10.5 by 15. Mickey Thompson ET drag. That'll be going on the car on my race stars. Hopefully they don't stick out too far compared to my drag radials, because these stick out a good amount. Stick out more on camera than they do in person. But, I mean, the offsets on these wheels aren't right. They're made for an SN95 and not for, you know, S197. So they have a 6.5 backspacing instead of a 7.5. So that's why I have that extra inch, you know, or so sticking out. So I don't know how this is gonna look on a slick, but we're gonna find out. And even if it looks stupid, I'm still gonna fucking run it, because I already bought them. And at least they were the right size. They're a 28. And a 275/60 is a 27.99 tire. So it is a 28. And it's the same, you know, sidewall and everything, same slick. Just had to change some shock settings on my Vikings, and we'll do some testing, get the bottle filled, and we'll be out there at the track soon. So I'll get back to you guys when I get these things on. All right, as you can see, the difference of the two, obviously these are a little more beat, but they hold stiff sidewall because it's a radial and not a slick. Obviously the basics on the slick, it's very soft. These have a good beat, just not a lot of hard sidewall, obviously without air in them, not like a radial. These have a lot of hard sidewall no matter what. But I'm gonna swap that one on the wheel, and we'll see how it looks on the car. Hopefully it doesn't stick out too far and look stupid. And we'll see where we go from there. Hopefully it's worked out. Clean the wheel up and get it all ready. Make it all pretty again too, because it needs a polish real bad. But I'll be back. So I got the one on. It's got 25 pounds of air in it. I would drop it down lower, but I really don't care much. I'm just gonna, you know, this is just a test and see how it looks. We do have BMR drag springs on it. The Viking struts are set up pretty stiff for the radial, because you can't really, it might move down just a little, but not much really, because they're set up pretty stiff. So I still gotta do this side. I took off 2 lug nuts. It's still on the jack, so don't worry, I'm not putting all the weight down, you know, the car. I mean, most of it, but there's 3 lug nuts tight on there still. So we're gonna see. Obviously you can see the difference between the radial and the slick. Looks like the slick sits a lot lower, actually. Got a lot more wheel gap. I was a little more scared of that. But definitely, how much it sticks out is actually fairly the same. Actually, probably less than what it was before. Well, a lot less than what the slick, I mean, the radial set out. Radial set out a lot more. Maybe we'll keep it on a slick then if I knew they would work out that well. Because, I mean, we're not far off. And, I mean, as long as I keep the suspension right, we should be all right and not hit the tire. Especially with that much of a gap. The other side has, like, 2-finger gap. This one, was at 3. It's about 3-finger. The other one might have 2. I mean, yeah, it's a difference. It's a big difference. It's pretty slick compared to the regular. Might have two. Yeah, this is two. Yeah, definitely an upgrade for this car. We'll see what happens when I get the other one on. We're gonna wash this thing and make it look good again. All right, so the car is washed. Obviously, you can tell. The slicks are on. I could throw some tire shine on them or something. I don't know how I'm feeling, because I know tire shine on this set and paint just, you know, slicks all over the side and shit. But hey, it's a track car. Who cares? But like as you can see, new tires are on. Sits pretty well, honestly. Like I said before, about 3 inches. Well, no, about an inch and a half. It'd be 3 fingers. But it turned out pretty good after it's all cleaned up. So hopefully this Friday we'll make it out to Atco Dragway for a test and tune. Now the price went back down and the weather may hold out.